What is up, everybody? You're watching The Kyle and Craig Show.
My name is Kyle.
My name is Craig. Today we're going to talk about the Super Bowl, the halftime show, and whatever else we happen to come up with. So, ask you, let you talk for a little while. Initial thoughts of the Super Bowl. I say Super Bowl 51. What are your thoughts?
Greatest Super Bowl ever that I've seen in a while. They were talking about it on ESPN Radio, and they were naming off a bunch of Super Bowls. Mm-hmm. That I was like, damn, that was pretty good. Of course, right now for the show, I'm blanking out.
All right, naturally.
The Patriots Giants game, the first one.
Okay.
With the
catch.
Yeah. That had the Tyree. Mm-hmm. That one. But this, I don't know, this one was really good. I mean, we were talking about it after the game. It was really like two games. It was a blowout in the first game, and it was a blowout in the second game. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It was like, it was 28-3, and then it was 34-0, so 31-0. I don't know why I said it the second time. 31-0. I don't know. It was pretty amazing, man. We were freaking out. I was going for the Patriots. He was going for the Atlanta, but he thought the Patriots were going to win anyways.
I was going for the Patriots. I was rooting for the Patriots, but I wouldn't have been mad if Atlanta won.
Yeah, exactly. And so we were just freaking out. We were super down. Had a little Super Bowl party. It's 28-3. We're like, oh my God.
Yeah, this is boring as shit. I felt like watching the
Denver Broncos get their ass kicked.
The Seahawks. Ago.
Yep. And then, man, they came back. It was just amazing, dude. It was just Tom Brady. You just felt it.
Yeah.
And then that catch by
Julian Edelman.
Julian Edelman was just absolutely amazing.
Showing up again, dude. He, like, that between that and his touchdown, was it? Did he throw for a touchdown in the last Super Bowl? It wasn't a touchdown, but it's like a pretty important touchdown. Yeah, yeah. That touchdown pass and that, like, he put his mark on, like, the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And shout out to Tom Brady. Like, everybody always talks about him with, like, not having, like, all-star receivers. But he makes his guys all-stars, dude. Like, you know, he makes them stand out. And they work hard for him and, like, really grind, you know?
Yeah.
Like the Julian Edelmans of the world and things like that. I freaking love him. So before we get really in-depth, like I said, I just wanted to ask you your initial thoughts. We also want to talk about the halftime show that happened this year. The halftime show and the commercials are a big part of the Super Bowl. It's something everybody talks about, all the news people cover. It's half the reason most of these people watch the stuff. This year, first and foremost, I thought the commercials were shit.
I can't remember one single
one of them. I was hardly
paying
attention, though, yeah.
I mean, we were, like, again, like, had a little party, and I was in and out of the room with the kids. But, like, the commercials I saw were just regular commercials.
Yeah.
There was nothing extravagant about them. Like,
there was no, like, multi-million-dollar, like, GoDaddy thing.
Yeah, there wasn't, like, no crazy celebrities. Mm-hmm. I mean, Tom Brady was in most of the commercials.
Yeah,
he?
Yeah.
Tom Brady was, like, in two or three commercials in his own Super Bowl.
Yeah. The rest were all local commercials also, which was I thought was weird. You know, like, we live in the Chicago area, and there was, like, commercials for, like, things in our area.
Yeah.
Like, in the middle of the Super Bowl. I'm like, isn't this, like, the national, like...
Yeah, usually they have, like, something funny, like that Doritos commercial from a couple years ago.
That's what I think.
Something cool, Seinfeld.
Ferris Bueller.
That Ferris Bueller's Super Bowl commercial always comes to mind. Like, they always have cool stuff, and this year was just so blah.
Yeah.
Just like the halftime show.
Just like the halftime show, and that's another thing I wanted to get into. Lady Gaga did the halftime show, and it was just incredibly...
blah.
If you can hear that. It was... you know?
It was just... It just was.
Not for me. You know what I'm saying? I did talk to some people. I had some friends who said that they liked it, but they're definitely more into, like, Lady Gaga and her music. But to the casual fan, like myself, I was...
It just wasn't a good show. It was just normal. It was just Lady Gaga doing some cool stuff, and she jumped from what appeared to be the top of the building, and it wasn't. It was only, like, halfway down, as you could see on the cell phone video that's going around the internet. And then she was on stage, and there was 1,000 people around her, and there were lights, people holding lights on the field. And then she'd walk off and change into something and do another song. And then she was up on a prop. And then she was up on another prop. And
it's cool and
it
all.
It was just not very... It was not Gaga-ish.
I'm sick of it. I gotta tell you. I was talking to my buddy about it. I'm real sick of the Super Bowl halftime shows. Like, I'd much rather just have one good artist, right? I know the last, like, 2 or 3 years, it was, like, Beyonce, Bruno Mars, and Coldplay. And it's like, what?
That was last year. It was one year.
And the year before that, it was the Red Hot... 2 years before that, Red Hot Chili Peppers and Beyonce and Bruno Mars.
Yeah.
And the year before that, it was another weirdo mix of people.
I think it was Beyonce the year before that.
And Beyonce and Destiny's Child.
Yeah.
And somebody else was there, too. I'm sick of it, dude. I just, like, I think just do a regular show... cut the shit with this Katy Perry coming in on a tiger. Oh, before that, it was Katy Perry, Lenny Kravitz, and Beyonce.
Yeah.
So with Destiny's Child. Like, cut the crap. Cut the fucking coming off the stage thing. I apologize for swearing. I will bleep it out. But I'm really sick of it. I don't like it. Like, just have, you don't have Bruno Mars, you don't have Beyonce, you don't have somebody. Just come in and put on a good show and, like, leave the antics aside. I'm tired of hearing, like, half of your song and then a DJ mix into another half of your song. Like, we don't need to hear every single you've had. Lady Gaga did, like, every song she's ever had on the radio ever in a 4-minute segment. Like, yeah. I'm tired of that stuff. Like, you just do what you came to do.
Yeah.
You know?
Interesting fact I learned that I told Craig on Super Bowl Sunday was that Outkast was supposed to do the halftime of the Super Bowl many a year ago, and they decided to not do it because they didn't want to cut any of their songs. And then the replacements for them was Justin Timberlake and Janet Jackson. And you got the whole titty scandal thing, and subsequently
the Super Bowl halftime show was changed
forever. Yeah, forever. It was changed forever. So if, like, Outkast had done it, A, it would have been a huge move for hip-hop.
Which would have been amazing.
But B, like, everything changed after that. They totally Disney'd the hell out of the halftime show, and it was just like, blah.
I wish I had the list in front of me. But, like, after that, they went so bland with it. It was, like, Rolling Stones, I think Paul McCartney, like, Hootie and the Blowfish,
yeah.
Prince, Madonna, and, like, all these, like, super safe people who weren't going to do anything crazy. Yeah. And then shortly after that is when they got into, like, Beyonce doing all this crazy stuff that they're going on now.
Some other stuff people were talking about was, like, if Lady Gaga was going to use her time during the halftime show to make a protest of some kind politically towards Donald Trump and his presidency. And she didn't. Is it disappointing? No. Because I don't know. There's time and place for everything. She could have maybe done something. I know Beyonce had the whole part of her show. Was that last year when they were all dressed in black for, like, the Black Lives Matter?
Yeah.
Or something of that nature. And a lot of people thought Gaga was going to do the same thing because she's always very been outspoken, and she didn't.
See, and the thing about that, if you don't mind me talking 2 seconds about the matter.
Yes, I mind.
If you ever watch, like, Mike and Mike, or I listen to ESPN Radio all the time, I know you do as well, sports are a
medium.
It's a break from reality, you know? We go to watch sports, and we do all these things to get away from the political aspect of the world as an escape. Sports are an escape of all the badness in the world, you know, like, even, like, the Olympics and stuff like that, like, years and years and years ago, back when, like, things were really bad in America with, like, protests and all that stuff.
Yeah.
And, like, then there was the Olympics and Jesse Owens, and he didn't, like, say anything but just holding up his fist, you know? Yeah. It's all the statement you needed to make. But, like, the Olympics at the time is the one time that we can all get together and, like, put all the BS aside, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I'm glad that she didn't make a political statement. Yes, every eye in America was staring at their TV. It would have been a perfect time for her to say something anti-Trump or whatever it is she wanted to speak on. But appreciate the sanctity of sports and that we're here to get away from that crap. Like, I can flip to CNN and see the same thing. This is our moment to, like, forget the rest of your day, forget the bad week you've had, Super Bowl Sunday. You know, enjoy it with your family. Let's not get political.
Would have made the show a lot more interesting, though.
Well, her
realizing in hindsight that the show wasn't as godly as we thought it would be, some sort of giant F Donald Trump sign would have been pretty cool in the background or something like that.
That can't be good. Yeah, I suppose you're right. But, you know, you get what I'm saying, though,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I get, like, what you're saying. I get what you're saying.
Like, take advantage of the spotlight that you have. You know, I get that. But, like, I'm just, it's the Super Bowl, it's about family, it's about getting together, it's about sports and the pinnacle of seasons and these guys' hard work. Let's not divert from that.
Do you think she ever even thought about it? Do you think it was ever even, like, a thing in her
100%.
Head? 100%. Yeah?
I'm sure that Fox thought about it. I'm sure everybody was freaking out. Like, yo, if she starts talking, pull the plug. You know? Do something, seriously.
Yeah. Because
I guess she had some sort of rant beforehand. I paid no attention to Gaga.
Yeah.
Beforehand, like, before getting on there or, like, on the red carpet or something where she was going off, and they thought just because of what she had said before the game, they were going to pull her from the halftime show.
Oh, yeah?
And throw, like, anybody up there.
Wow.
Yeah.
But that didn't happen. Messed up.
So they were, like, on their toes.
It's also a really big opportunity for her. Like, you can't get on a bigger stage in the world of music. So You know?
Yeah, and that's what I'm saying.
Not a good look to get pulled halfway through the show.
Yeah. Dude, good.
Would have been a bad look for the NFL.
Yeah.
You kind of just swallow that pill and deal with it afterwards.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Back to the point about, like, not the political aspect of things, but, like, the putting on a show thing. Like, I want to see just, like, Adele. I think Adele would be a good halftime show.
Mm-hmm.
Get on stage. If you're watching an Adele concert,
no.
It's interesting. She's just singing. It's just her and a mic stand.
Yeah, we got to entertain.
Dude, but, like,
millions of people.
Yes, but this dancing, like, we don't have the attention span to get through your song.
Uh-huh.
If your song's good enough, we'll be fine.
Yeah, I guess so.
But you need the flashing lights and a moonwalking gorilla, like, for our attention, like, to entertain us. Like, no, like, you, like, that's what I'm saying. If you watch an Adele concert, it's crazy. Like, it's just her and a mic stand, and it's everybody shuts up and, like, listens. And, like, that'd be interesting to see.
Yeah.
Or Beyonce, or, any, you know, any anybody. Be like, let's focus more on the music. And, like, let that be the entertainment versus all the, like, smoke and mirrors.
Or if someone can just come up with something completely different than what everyone else has done over the past 5 years, you know?
Yeah.
If, like, anybody can have people not on the field holding hands.
Yeah.
That'd be pretty awesome. I mean, it wasn't a dome. They opened the dome so they could do the drone thing. And that was really cool. So maybe next year someone figures out a way to get those things flying around a stadium.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Inside. And do some stuff with them that way.
There's that one drone I was telling you about that was carrying Casey Neistat, the YouTuber, around. Yeah, like, this is Samsung made a drone. Did I tell you? I don't know if you're listening.
Oop.
Like, the size of my bed.
Really?
And he used it to pull him on a snowboard.
Yeah.
But it could also, like, full-on lift him in the air. Strap somebody to one of those things. That'd be interesting.
Yeah.
Have them fly around the stadium.
That'd be pretty awesome. Super unsafe, but pretty cool.
Risky.
Yeah.
Gotta risk it to get the biscuits.
So, consensus is, halftime show wasn't very good.
Boo.
The game... was much the ending better. Of the game was absolutely amazing. I know last week Facebook fans,
our friends on Facebook,
wanted us to talk about Tom Brady's legacy, if he lost or if he won, and we talked about that. And well, a week later, now that we know he won, his legacy is what we said it would be. He's the greatest quarterback of all time. There's no denying it. It's not even a question. He's got 5 Super Bowl rings, 4 Super Bowl MVPs. He's got all the records in the playoffs, most wins, most touchdowns, most yards, or most games. I think most touchdowns, too, as well. And that's just in the playoffs. He's got 2 regular season MVPs. I think he's, like, 2nd in wins.
No, he's first in wins.
First in wins?
Manning's Super Bowl win was his 200th career win.
Oh, yeah,
and
yeah,
Tom Brady
passed
him up in, like, week, like, 10.
Yeah, so he's 1 in wins. I think he's, like, 4th or 3rd in passing. He's, like, 2nd or 3rd in touchdowns.
Yeah.
I mean, it's not even a question anymore.
It's not a question. Yeah. All this did was solidify, like, a little bit more. And, go ahead.
Go ahead.
What? I don't want to let you talk.
No. It's cool. It's just, like, the way he did it. Like, in my head, like, if he had won, like, 74-0, we would have been like, oh, my God, Tom Brady. Crazy the way he came back. Greatest quarterback. Or crazy way that he won. Complete domination. Greatest quarterback of all time.
Yeah.
Or on the opposite side of the coin, you have this. You have down 28-3. And you score 31 unanswered points and make the greatest comeback in Super Bowl history. It's like, that's Tom Brady.
Yeah, that
you know
is
what
Tom
I mean?
Brady.
Like, that's the greatest quarterback of all time.
Yeah. We were sitting there, so we had a little Super Bowl party, like Kyle had mentioned. And obviously his 2 kids were there, Felix and Kane. And I was sitting with Felix, and he was all upset. Because whenever we're going for a team, we tell him, like, yo, we're going for the Patriots. Boo, Falcons, you know? So Felix is sitting there, and he was all sad because, like, he was playing in the room with his brother. Then he came out. And he sat next to me on that little, like, thing you got, the little, not futon, it's not armoire, something like that, whatever
something
it
like
is.
That, whatever.
And he's like, oh, we're losing. I'm like, yeah, but Felix, look, we got a lot of time left. There was probably, I think there was, at this point, we were down, it was 28-3 or whatever it was, with, like, 12 minutes left in the third quarter. Look, we got a lot of time left, and it's Tom Brady. Like, yeah, we're losing. Never counted out. Swear to God, I said that.
Yeah.
And then...
And it was kind of funny because later, it wasn't 28-3 anymore. I think it was like 28-9. And I was sad. I was like, buddy, we're losing. I'm so sad. He's like, yeah, but we scored. And he was like optimistic about it, versus me being negative about it. So he had the right attitude.
Yeah. So there you go. And dude, for real though, like, you can't count Tom Brady out ever. You know, couldn't count him out after Deflategate. You couldn't count him out after the, like, playoffs. Couldn't count him out after... anything, dude. Like, his whole career is just, like, a pinnacle of
comeback.
Amazing.
Underdog.
You know? And, like, to have that, like, 10-year gap between Super Bowls is also another crazy thing, too. You know? Like, to win your first three before 2005, and then he wasn't another one. He didn't win another one until 2015. And, like, shows no, like,
yeah,
who's
yeah.
your pick for next year? Mine's Patriots.
Yeah.
Yeah, like, you know, like, shows no signs of slowing. He'll be 40 before next season starts. He easily finish his career with six.
Yeah.
Yeah,
only one more. Yeah.
Yeah.
He's going to play for, like, another 3-4 years.
Yeah.
And I was listening to the radio again, and they were saying the type of system that they have, this dink and dunk system where he doesn't have to chuck the ball, you know, 40, 50 yards.
Yeah.
Even 5-6 times a game, he doesn't have to do that. He just throws it over the middle and lets his playmakers do what they got to do, especially when Gronk is in the game.
That's what I was going to say next.
You could do that for forever. Age isn't even a number at that point, especially the way he eats and the way he works out and the way he takes care of his body, and he's just throwing it 5 yards at a time. You could play for
it's
forever.
It's like the quarterback equivalent of, like, the last 5 years of Ray Allen's career. It's like, stand in the corner, we'll get you the ball.
Yeah.
Like, you know, you go there, we'll take care of you.
You don't have to run.
Yeah,
just
same thing with,
shoot
like,
the ball.
Yeah, like, do what you do and just stay there. Tom Brady, like, just get us the ball, let your playmakers make it work. Not saying that he isn't doing anything, you know, because that's sort of like the last year of Peyton Manning's career, you know? Yeah,
well, he's doing a lot more than
that. Yeah, no, that's what I'm saying. Like
I'm just saying that's the system they're running. Yeah. Peyton Manning only did that because Peyton Manning could only do that.
Yeah, but Tom Brady is only doing that so that he can do that for a lot longer.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, he could have gone guns out, you know, the last 2 or 3 years.
Yeah.
Like, slanging.
I don't even think they're doing it on purpose. I just think they happen
that's
to find a
system
that works.
Yeah. And
Belichick. Second Super Bowl in 3 years. One Super Bowl away next year. If they win, that's another dynasty.
Yeah.
You know? I saw this picture of, like, the Patriots next to the Spurs. Yeah. There's, like, 5 titles in 16 years dynasties. And you could call them that because 5 and 16 is a lot. But, like, if we're doing it, like, you need to win 3 and 4 years to be considered a dynasty. Well, they did that once. And now if they repeat next year, he's got 2 dynasties. He's the Michael Jordan of basketball.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You're going to three-peat twice. Yeah. You're going to have 2 dynasties. 10 years apart. What?
I mean, I think you're misusing the word dynasty there a little
Why?
Bit. Well, like, the dynasty is the fact that the Spurs and the Patriots have dominated their two
sports.
Oh,
I know. And that's why
length.
That's a good point. That's why I said I said you can make that argument. 5 and 16, yes, that is a dynasty. That's, like, as a whole.
Because even those years that they didn't make it, they were still... They've never not been in contention.
Yeah, no, but they didn't win. So I'm just saying there's a general consensus in sports.
If you're winning
about 3 and 4, you're considered a dynasty. To have 2 dynasties... 10 years apart.
Okay, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
It just
speaks volumes to him and Belichick.
Yeah.
What I'm saying.
Yeah. That's a very good way. I'm sorry I misunderstood.
Yeah.
To what I was saying earlier about the 10 years apart thing.
Yeah.
You know, like, they did it then, and then they did it 10 years later and show no signs of slowing down.
Yeah, exactly.
I had the stats here. Just look at, like, his Super Bowl stats are just incredible. Like, the numbers he puts up. 442 passing yards.
When?
In the Super Bowl.
Okay, in the Super Bowl game. All right.
Yeah. 2 touchdowns, 1 interception. Threw a pick six, which threw me for a loop.
Yeah.
You know, usually, like, pick six means, like, no bueno. It's pretty much done.
Kind of like a kick return touchdown in the Super Bowl. I mean, kind of means, like, it's probably over.
Yeah. Bears. Or an onside kick to start the second half. Dab. Count so mad. One day we'll get into, like, who our teams are.
Our teams were.
Well, you were.
Oh.
I'm still a Saints fan.
Yeah, because your team's so relevant. My team sucks.
My team's so irrelevant.
You still got Drew Brees. You still have your team. My team is not my team anymore.
It's just Drew Brees.
That's all you need, man. The Colts still had Peyton Manning, and I'd be like, oh, shit, let's go Colts.
You got Andrew Luck. Be a Colts fan all day if you want to. My thing is, if Drew Brees retires in the next couple of years, guess who's still a Saints fan?
Not you.
This guy. Think I'm a
You're
Jets
not
fan,
fan
for shits and
not
giggles?
Not Eagles fan no more.
I was 9.
So what? Okay.
I don't know. Yeah, I don't know what to tell you,
okay.
But I'm still a
All
Jets
right, well,
fan.
Whatever. We're getting way off topic.
Yeah, we are.
But, yeah, his stats in the game were absolutely amazing.
Yeah,
so
incredible.
Many records that day. First time we went into overtime. Biggest comeback. His 7th Super Bowl appearance. His 5th Super Bowl win. Belichick's 5th Super Bowl win. I think there were a bunch more, to be honest. I saw this list of, like, 20. And, I was like, oh my God. Like, it was a historic night. Like, whether you were rooting for them or not, whether you were rooting for the Patriots to lose, because you hate Tom Brady and Bill Belichick and what the Patriots stand for, like, you saw history. And that's just what is amazing. That's why I root for Tom Brady.
That's why we watch sports.
Exactly. Like, I kind of agree with Sylvie. He said it. Like, there's so many people in the world rooting against Tom Brady. But when I have no playing interest in the game, I want to see greatness.
Mm-hmm.
You know? And at the time and place, I absolutely hated the Patriots when the Giants beat them that 18-0 season.
Mm-hmm.
In hindsight, I kind of wish the Patriots would have won, because I could have said I saw an undefeated season ending with a Super Bowl championship
in my lifetime. Yeah.
And so for Tom Brady to win his fifth, that's just me being able to see history made. You know what I mean? If Atlanta won...
Good for Atlanta.
Yeah, good for Atlanta, and it wouldn't have diminished Tom Brady's legacy like we said, but for him to get five, like, you're witnessing history.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
This is like... watching
LeBron James,
yeah, dude.
Except he loses.
Like, the two things I'll remember, you know, like, we always hear our parents talking about, or our parents, you know, that generation, talk about Michael, right? Talk about Michael, talk about the Cowboys.
Yeah.
You know, and, like, those were the things that dominated those sports for that time period. We're going to get to say to our kids that we saw LeBron James through his whole career from 03 to 2020, whenever he finally retires, you know, like, the greatness, the dominance of a sport, you know, and Tom Brady as well, is what I'm saying. Like, the true, you can't hate on greatness, and you know, that's what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
And I love that we get to see it. You know, there was a while there where, like, there wasn't that complete dominant aspect.
Yeah.
You know, I don't know what I'm trying to say, but I love that he came back and, like, did it and has won two in the past 2-3 years. And is probably – I'd bet most of my money on them winning one more before he retires, even if it is some sort of, like, his last year, Peyton Manning.
Yeah. I'm sure he'll get one more, dude. Yeah. Six, and then I don't think anybody will ever touch that. So that'll be one of those
that'll
sports
be like
records.
Lou Gehrig type.
Yeah, exactly, that no one's ever going to touch. So it'll be pretty amazing.
Yeah. On the other hand, the Falcons didn't do bad. Talk about blowing a lead. That sucked. But they looked so dominant. They figured out the Patriots the first half of that game. Till Tom Brady flicked that switch.
Yeah, and the defense wasn't pressuring him anymore. Yeah. And the offense was just making really bad calls. I mean, they had like a minute something left, dude. All they had to do was take two kneel downs. The Patriots still had three timeouts, so no clock would have been up, run off.
Yeah.
But they would have kicked the field goal. They wouldn't have been up. They would have been up by 10 or 11 instead of 8. They would have been up by 11 instead of 8, and the game would have been over. Like, there's no way you're going to go score 2-point conversion, onside kick, and go score again.
Yeah.
And there's just not enough time in the world. You know what I mean? Even for Tom Brady, you can't outrun the clock.
Yeah.
So they were just making really bad plays down the end of the game. I mean, Julio Jones was crazy good.
Would have been the MVP of the Super Bowl.
He made those two godly catches.
Yeah.
Absolutely amazing. But this is kind of like what Atlanta did last year, for those that don't know. Like, they started out 5-0. And then they lost a bunch of games where they were up on people, and that team came roaring back just like the Patriots did and lost. The difference between last year and this year is that this year, when they were up, they didn't let off the gas.
Yeah.
They stepped on the throat and crushed it. You know what I mean?
Matty Ice didn't like...
That's why they had the number one offense in the league.
And that's why they had the MVP of the league.
Yeah, exactly. So, like, they reverted back to their old ways last year. In the biggest game, I don't know if it's because it's the regular season, nothing to lose, let's gunsling it, you know what I mean? And against the Green Bay, it was never even, like, close. Like, they just killed the game, period, you know what I mean?
So even if they let off the gas, they were up by so much. So
yeah, but, like, in the Super Bowl, in the biggest moments...
Against Tom Brady.
They got scared, they got complacent or panicked that if we keep doing... If we don't do the right things, we're going to mess it up.
Yeah.
So they were trying to play it way too safe. The defense wasn't pressuring anymore. They had three sacks in the first two series of the game. And the rest of the game after that, second half, especially the fourth quarter, just wasn't that good.
Yeah.
And then another thing I wanted to touch on, too, besides Atlanta doing okay, they had a good season, but they lost, is that everyone's saying that, like, it could possibly be rigged.
Yeah.
And it's just a big fat no. Because if anyone's been following the NFL for the last 2 years, there's nothing more dramatic than what's been going on between Tom Brady and Roger Goodell. And the last thing Roger Goodell wanted was for the Patriots to somehow end up back in the Super Bowl and winning a championship.
Yeah.
Because it makes him look stupid. It makes it look like...
It's all a waste of time?
Not a waste of time, because if he cheated, he cheated. But, like, he didn't need those flat balls to win championships. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, this was dragged on ridiculously when no one thought it should have been dragged on that far. He got suspended. They went 3-1 in his time of suspension.
The entire next year, they were on his butt about it and checking all the balls and making sure everything's good. And last year, he went on an incredible stretch and almost won the Super Bowl. He lost to the Broncos in the AFC Championship.
Yeah.
But you know what I'm saying? He got that far and then an incredible season last year. And then this year is when the suspension finally kicked in, and then to go on, only throw 2 interceptions in 12 games and win the Super Bowl.
Yeah. And if anyone saw the post-game
presser
where like they give them the championship, if you watch the Super Bowls, you know what happens. They hand the NBC, the CBS, the Fox guy, the mic. So Terry Bradshaw should have had the mic first. He would have said something like, "Wow, what a Super Bowl. Here's Roger Goodell to hand the Patriots the championship." He would have handed the mic to Roger Goodell. Roger Goodell would have said what he said and then handed the Super Bowl trophy
to the Patriots. Like, he means like this.
Yeah.
Not like take the mic from his hands.
But that's the order it would have gone. It would have gone Terry, Roger, hand off the trophy, back to Terry to ask questions. Roger Goodell grabbed the mic right away.
Yeah.
Terry was standing there awkward as shit. You could tell he was like, this is not supposed to be happening. He said what he had to say. He got booed the entire time. He was trying to be super stern about it and then like walked off the stage real quick.
Yeah.
And it's just like, that's not the way it's supposed to go. So no. You could tell.
He wasn't happy about it.
He either wasn't happy about it or he just kind of wanted to get out the way for like maybe afterthought, like screen time.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Like the less time he was on that stage, the less chance the media got to get photos or something. I don't know what his mindset was. But it was not the way it was supposed to go.
Go out there, stick to the cards, get the hell off the stage, exactly. You know, sort of thing. So as much as, like, Goodell would have never let it be rigged in the Patriots' favor, it's just dumb. The conspiracies I've seen, I remember it was overtime, right? And people have this clip. You can find it. I'll link to it below if I find it. People have it on, like, DVR and all that jazz. And a graphic came up and it said, Patriots win Super Bowl with touchdown.
Mm-hmm.
When they were just starting the drive in overtime.
Oh, yeah.
So everybody's freaking out. Like, look, the graphic already exists. Patriots win Super Bowl with a touchdown. You know, it's clear. Like, they're saying, like, rigged. Yeah. Like, look, it's already planned. They know they're going to go down and score.
I'm sure it's just Photoshop.
No. It's real. But they're taking it in the dumbest context I've ever heard.
Why?
It's informing you. The Patriots will win the Super Bowl with a touchdown. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Like, touchdown wins the game.
When does they ever say that, though?
Dude, I all the time. Like,
who doesn't know that? Everyone knows that.
Why would a nobody knows that. Because overtime rules. Nobody understands that shit. Patriots win Super Bowl with a touchdown. Okay. It's informing you. Right. Like, if they score a touchdown, the Patriots win the Super Bowl. That's what that graphic was telling you. So if you guys saw that or you had questioned that in any way, it's informing you about what's about to happen. And, like, Patriots win Super Bowl with a touchdown.
Yeah.
You know, it could have also said, like, they're not going to put it, field goal doesn't win the game. Falcons get the ball back. Like, no. Like, Patriots win Super Bowl with touchdown.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? So that was a big thing I saw circulating in the internet. Was like, that was, like, part of the rigged thing.
Another thing was the photo of the last play when the Patriots running back dove toward the end zone. And there's a clip of his knee in the ground before the ball crosses the line.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I'm not saying that's real or someone photoshopped it. But the way the play went is he jumped across the line. The ref threw their hands up. And that was it. It's a touchdown. The confetti came down. Everyone ran on the field. I mean, even Tom Brady was kind of halfway concerned. He was still looking up at the screen when Matty Ice came over to congratulate him. And he looked like he wasn't sure if they were winning either. He was kind of trying to tell the media to back up.
Yeah.
And I felt the same way. Like, they should review this. They should have, like, touchdown, but let's review it. If his knee was down, his knee was down. I don't even care. I'm not a Patriots fan or a Falcons fan, so I don't go either way.
Let's make sure we got
it. He would have scored the next play either way. You know what I mean? Like, the Patriots would have scored.
There's no
way
they didn't. Yeah, that's what I was going to say.
But, like,
Malcolm Butler.
Yeah, you know what I mean? Exactly. But, like,
very easy for them not to score.
It's just too late now. There's nothing you could do about it. If that's the right call and he wasn't in, then that just sucks.
And it's like the conclusive evidence thing. Literally, that one picture, that pause frame right there, mm-hmm. is the only angle where it looks like he maybe didn't get in. And even then,
they showed the clip like four times
from
afterwards.
Four different angles. Every angle you look at, they got it. Mm-hmm. His knee was down after he had crossed the plane. Yeah. That one picture. So it's like, okay, we have these six videos of he made it, and you have that one blurry picture where it sort of looks like maybe he didn't. Because like the football is like clearly in like this jolt, you know, forward motion. Yeah. So like
It's really hard to tell.
It's hard to say. And like tie goes to the runner.
Yeah. It's just too late.
And it wasn't even a tie. It was definitely a touchdown. Without a shadow of a doubt he crossed the plane.
Yeah. And now it's just too late now. So it's obviously wasn't rigged. You know, the Patriots just had one of those amazing runs. You know what I mean? We saw it over the last, what, 2 years?
Mm-hmm.
Warriors blew a 3-1 lead. Indians blew a 3-1 lead. Falcons blew a 28-3 lead. Just happens in sports all the time.
Panthers had that incredible season of losing the Super Bowl. You know, people just blowing stuff.
Yeah, exactly. You know, like, yeah. Like, it just happens.
That's not
so
rigged, man. Conor McGregor losing to Nate Diaz. Like,
rigged.
I promise you, these people rigged. Don't plan these things. Like, you know, like, nobody wants their star boys
to lose.
Nor do they want, like, in Roger Goodell, like, the Patriots are, like, the star boys of the league. But, like, the league doesn't like them right now. Yeah. So the last thing they wanted to do was to have these dudes win the Super Bowl.
Yep.
But that's our general consensus on the whole ordeal. I enjoyed the whole thing.
It was pretty amazing.
Yeah, it's good. It's great. It's a great time. Can't wait for next season. Give us a week or so. We'll get in real some hockey mood. And then off-season things. And the NBA trade deadline's coming up, so we'll touch on that next week.
Yeah, but that's like the end of football season. And so we still got a long NBA season till June. And then hockey right around the same time. So we're going to be pretty full of hockey and basketball stuff. But today,
March Madness when it comes up.
Yeah, March Madness when it comes up. Get our tournaments going. But today we just wanted to strictly keep it to the Super Bowl because, to be honest, there's no bigger story in sports right now than the Patriots beating the Falcons in Super Bowl 51.
Yeah. So, like we said in the beginning, we're going to keep it a nice short show. Like, subscribe, comment down below. We really got to get this fan interaction going. Next week we're going to do some Snapchat questions. So you guys can... I'll do post on Facebooks and the whole jazz when it comes time. We'll have you guys send in questions via Snapchat, and then you'll get to be on the show, you know, with your little like face on the screen.
Nice.
And we'll do fan questions that way, you know, whether it's sports related, try and keep it sports related. But if you guys just have random questions for Kyle and myself, then we'll answer those live on the show and have some fun with that.
Yes.
Other than that, we'd like to thank you guys for watching the Kyle and Craig Show.
My name is Kyle.
My name is Craig. See you guys later.
See ya.